Welcome to another tutorial in MATLAB. In this series, we are looking into the concept of stateflow and how it works in MATLAB. In this video, we will be looking into the second type of temporal logic that is there in MATLAB, stateflow. In the last tutorial, we have seen absolute time logic where we will be using the second command, which is mentioned over here, 5 second, and we did the transition. Now, in this tutorial, we will see how we can use relative time logic in this particular transition. So, in this case, we will be now using ticks instead of seconds. Instead of seconds, we will be using ticks now, and now we will simulate this particular model. So before simulating, let's convert this particular constant into one so that we can go from on to off state. So let's simulate this particular model. So while simulating, so instead of using ticks, we will be using tick, which is the right word. Now we will start simulating the model. As you can see, we have started with the default state, which is the on state. Now we will step into the model. As you can see, the time at the round side now increased. Again, it increased 2 times. Now it is increased 3 times, 4 times, 5th time. So exactly at the 5th tick, the transition happened, which is exactly at the 5th sample time, the transition happened. And if we step again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then the other transition is not happening. We need to change the logic from 1 to 0 for the switch. Now, if we step 5 times, then we will be able to get back to the on state. 1, okay. So now we are at the on state. Now let's change again the constant logic to 1. So that we will be able to jump into the off state. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, if we change this to 0, then we will be again going back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we are at the on state. This is how relative time logic works in stateflow, which is one kind of temporal logic, which is sample time based logic. And it has also a dependency. It depends on the sample time of the model. Here, the sample time is 0.4 second, which is decided automatically with the help of the variable step solver. So the solver settings and configuration you can change over here, and you can change the behavior of the whole model based on the timing logic. If you select here fixed solver, then you will have different option. Suppose I want to simulate this model at 0.2 sample time, means one sample time contains 0.2 second. Press OK. Then if I step in the model, then exactly at 1 second, I will be able to do the transition. So let's check whether the transition is happening at the 1 second or not. Okay, we need to change the logic to 1, stop the simulation. Let's check whether it is happening at exactly at 1 second or not. Okay, we are at the on state. Now we are at 0.4 second, 0.6 second, 0.8 second, 0. Then now at 1 second. So we are able to do the transition at exactly 1 second, which is the 5th tick, as we have the sample time of 0.2 second. If we change this now to 0.4 second, then we will be able to do the transition at 2 second. So let's change it from 0.2 to 0.4. Okay. Now let's simulate this particular model with the defined condition. Here we have 1 as the input to the switch. So we will be able to transit from on to off state. So now step. We are at 0.4 second, we are at 0.8 second, we are at 1.2 second, we are at 1.6 second, we are at 2 second. Now exactly at the 2 second, we are able to do the transition. So this is how tick-based logic or the temporal logic will work, and it will vary with the sample time. So we need to be careful what should be the sample time for the tick-based logic model. If the sample time is not the same, then the behavior will be different. In case you are liking our channel, please consider subscribing and please share your comments or suggestion in the comment box so that we can improve your experience of learning MATLAB in this channel. Happy learning MATLAB and stay connected. Thank you.